Welcome all of you. Today we'll discuss the fourth chromosome type of the chromosomal aberrations. The questions may be asked like the what are the chromosomal aberrations? Discuss translocation with reference to their origin and genetic effect in human being. So as you know, in previous lecture we have discussed about the deletion, duplication, and inversion chromosomal aberrations. So today we have discussed the last one type of the chromosomal aberration is the translocation. The introductory part is the same like the other I will discuss in previous lectures. So directly we start about the translocation. So it is also the types of the structural aberrations. So what is mean by translocation? So translocation, that means there is a shifting or transfer of the part of the chromosome. But here we transfer the segment into the non-homologous chromosome. It's called as the translocation. So as you know, normally in that translocation, the transfers of the segment will be takes place in between the two different chromosomes, that is non-homologous chromosome. So as you seen in this figure, the chromosome A, B, C, D, E, F is the one chromosome, and second one is the V, W, X, Y, Z. So here there is the shifting or transfers of the segment will be takes place. So there is the shifting the segment of the first chromosome AB, that shift on the another chromosome, that is from V, W, X, Y, Z. So after the transfer translocations of the segment, the segments will be formed like the C, D, E, F. It is the one chromosome, and another one is the AB, V, W, X, Y, Z. So here translocation, that means there is the transfers of the segment in between the non-homologous chromosome. So what is the origin of translocation? So according to the origins of the translocation, there are three different types. First type of the translocation is the simple translocation. So what happened in the simple translocation? There is the only single break will be occurs in chromosomes, and the broken end get attached to the another chromosome at the one end. But the simple translocation will occur very rarely. So for example, in chromosome A, B, C, D, E, F, in that there is the single break will be takes place, and due to this single breaking, the segments will be cut out, and this segment that will be attached on the non-homologous chromosome, that is V, W, X, Y, Z. So after simple translocation, the chromosome that will form as like the C, D, E, F, it is the one chromosome, and the non-homologous another one is the A, B, then V, W, X, Y, Z. So here the simple translocations will be formed, and in that they rarely occur this simple translocation. Then second type of this translocation, that is the shift translocation. So in shift translocation, there is the shifting of the segment that will be takes place, and the cutted segment that will be inserted interstitially into the non-homologous chromosome. Interstitially, that means that will be inserted in the middle part of the chromosome. So in shift chromosome, there will be broken segment of the chromosome, one chromosome, get inserted interstitially on the non-homologous chromosome. So for example, there is a A, B, C, D, E, F is the one chromosome. The cut will be takes place at the segment B and C. So after the translocation, this cutting segment, that is BC, that will be inserted interstitially on the non-homologous chromosome, and that is in B, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. So here, in between, after the U, V, the cutted segment that will be interstitially inserted. So the segment that is U, V, B, C, W, then X, Y, Z. So this is the shift translocation. That means the cutting segment that will be interstitially inserted into the non-homologous chromosomes. Then last one is the reciprocal translocation. The third type of the translocation, reciprocal translocation. Reciprocal, that means these segment of the one chromosome that will be exchanged with the another one non-homologous chromosome, but it may be in heterozygote. Heterozygote, it means in the different chromosome, that is heterozygous. So here normal chromosome is the A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O. This is the two homologous chromosomes. Heterozygous chromosome. There are the two different chromosomes, their segments will be different. So after the reciprocal translocation, the segment of this H, I, J, K. So in after H, I, J, K, there is the L, M, N, O. So this L, M, N, O segment that will be transferred at the place of the D, E, F, G. So there is the heterozygotic translocations of the segments will be takes place. That means from there is the reciprocal. Normally हमने जो ऊपर वाले जो shift and single translocation देखा वहाँ पे खाली जो एक segment transfer हो रहा है. But here in reciprocal translocation जो फर्स्ट क्रोमोसोम का जो सेगमेंट है वो सेकंड क्रोमोसोम पे जाके शिफ्ट हो रहा है और जो सेकंड क्रोमोसोम के ऊपर जो भी सेगमेंट है वो फर्स्ट क्रोमोसोम पे आके शिफ्ट हो रहा है. तो देयर इज द रेसिप्रोकल ट्रांसलोकेशंस विल बी टेक्स प्लेस इन द हेटरोजाइगोटिक कंडीशन एंड इन सिंपल एंड द शिफ्ट ट्रांसलोकेशन देयर इज द ओनली द कटिंग सेगमेंट दे विल बी ट्रांसफर ऑन द अनदर क्रोमोसोम. So all of you got these types of translocation? All of you are understand this point? Simply there is the three types. First one simple translocation, second one shift translocation, and third one is the reciprocal translocation. Simple and shift translocation, there is the transfer of segment from one chromosome to another. In reciprocal, there is the reverse. It is also happening in the non-homologous chromosomes, but there is the shifting of chromosome from first segment that will be transferred on the second non-homologous chromosome, and second jo non-homologous chromosome hai, that cutting part also shifted on the first chromosomes. So this is the types of this translocation. Then second one is the cytology and genetic effect. So in case of the cytology, the translocation creates the new linkages relationship. Due to there is the directly segment that will be added on the another chromosome, so the sequence of these chromosomes that will be changed and they can create the new relations or new characters. So definitely it will be helpful for different purposes. Then in translocation, Heterozygotes observe considerable degree of meiotic irregularity. So due to the translocation difference, heterozygotes may be formed. So if the heterozygotes have formed, the characters that will be not regularly observed in generation to generation, the characters are also irregularly affected. Then in case of the human being, first of all, the example is the Oinothera. So Oinothera, in case of the Oinothera, in that there is a reciprocal translocations will be occur, and in 7 of its chromosome pairs, its member are permanently heterozygous. So in case of the Oinothera, the reciprocal translocations will be observed, and in that case, the different permanently different types of heterozygotes are observed in generation to generation. So here the reciprocal translocation in Oinothera, maybe these questions may be asked in MCQ. So in Oinothera, the reciprocal translocations will be observed, and in that mostly the all its 7 chromosomes that will be affected due to this reciprocal translocations. Then in case of the human, so in human also these translocations types of are occurred, and due to this translocation different types of genetic effects will be observed. So first example of the translocation is the Robertsonian translocation. So in Robertsonian translocation, what's happening in that case? So there is the breaking of short arm of the non-homologous chromosomes will be displaced, and small segment of that chromosomes that will be lost, and large segment that will be fused with the centromeric region. So as a result, there is a new large submetacentric chromosomes that will be observed, and these symptoms that referred as the Robertsonian translocation. So for MCQs, mostly these on the genetic effect, many MCQs may be asked. So here in case of the Robertsonian translocation, it is due to the loss of the segment, or the loss of the short or small segment of the chromosome, the Robertsonian translocations are occurred. Then the second example of the translocation in human being are the chronic myelogenous leukemia. So this chronic myelogenous leukemia disease or effect that may be affected due to this a part of long arm of chromosome 22 is translocated in chromosome number 9. So this translocation apparently they will be activated the oncogenes. So ultimately these oncogenes that will be produced due to this new formed segment. So there is also genetic characters that will be affected. So here these long arm of the chromosome 22 that will be translocated into the chromosome number 9. So due to this, the oncogenes that will be created some genetic or chronic condition, that is the cancerous, they will be cancerous cells. So they increasing their number very rapidly. So they created the genetic effect on the cell. So here these are the two main examples regarding the human being, and instead human being also this translocation will be affected the Oinothera species. So all of you are got this point, translocation So here your chromosomal aberrations point will be over. In that we have detailed discuss about the structural aberrations, and in structural aberration we have discussed the four different types of structural aberrations. First one is the deletion, then second one is the duplication, third one is the inversion, and last one is the translocation. So I hope all of you have got these all types of structural aberrations.